Hi, and welcome back to another car conversation with your coach, me, Michelle. So listen, you guys, I'm excited. I'm excited because I'm just excited for no real reason. I will say this, my morning was a little busy because I woke up knowing that today was Wednesday. As a matter of fact, happy Wednesday to each and every one of you. And somehow or another, as the day progressed, I was thinking today was Thursday and tomorrow was Friday. I was thinking, oh, thank you, Jesus, tomorrow's Friday. And I'm thinking, Michelle, how in the world did that happen? But sometimes it's like that when your day gets to be a little busy and a little hectic. And speaking of, my evening was going to be a little busy and hectic, but now it's not. So I'm so thankful for that. One mini meeting that I had with the leadership team of the women's ministry, we're not meeting. And so that's great. However, a meeting that I had for tomorrow, a board meeting that I had for tomorrow, has now been moved to today. And because they're on Central Time, they want to meet at 7:30, which means that's 8:30 my time, which means we probably won't be done till about 9:30, perhaps 9:45. Not really feeling that. So I may have to, I know we have to vote on something, so we may have to do that early in the meeting. So if I have to get off the call, then it's not going to mess up anything. But other than that, y'all, I'm still on my editing project. I am, fingers crossed, hopefully by Saturday, I can tell you all that I am done. But I did promise Ross that by the end of this week, far as I'm concerned, the end of my week is Sunday. Monday begins my week, so I have until Sunday. I'm not trying to drag it to Sunday, but I have until Sunday to get this project done because I was up late last night editing. And I'm hoping that I can get it all done because the next book is already almost done that he's writing, so that will have to be edited and formatted and all that other good stuff. But we'll cross that bridge when we get there. Now, let's jump into today's video because today's topic is stop letting people use you. Let me say that one more time. Stop letting people use you, okay? And now I'm going to be using some stoic principles as I go along, but I just really, and it's funny because this topic has been on my mind for a while. Not that I'm being used, but just because people get used so often and it's really sad. First of all, it's sad that folks think that it's okay to go around using people. And it's sad when people don't see that they are being used. And so I just want to talk about that a little bit today. So, and excuse me, y'all, because my sinuses are draining a little bit. So being kind is a virtue, but when it's in excess, you can find yourself in situations where someone is taking advantage of you or even manipulating you. Have you ever, and I want you to think about this, have you ever felt your kindness has become your weakness? I want you to really think about that. You don't have to respond. You can if you want to, but I just want you to think about that. Have you ever thought about whether or not your kindness has become your weakness? If so, then this video is definitely for you. So here is how you can balance kindness with self-care. Because as I go through these six things, you'll see how important that really is. You've got to be able to balance kindness with self-care, meaning you can be kind to people, but you've got to take care of yourself as well. You cannot allow people to walk all over you. So number one, and everything as always will be in the description box. Number one, identify when someone is taking advantage of you. So in order to solve any problem, you must first identify it. You cannot fix what you will not or cannot identify. That's the real reason why people are being mistreated and taken advantage of, because you haven't identified the fact that you are being taken advantage of. So if you aren't sure whether or not you're being used, ask yourself these questions. Do you feel used or manipulated after dealing with this person or these people? These are questions you ask yourself. Do I feel used or manipulated after dealing with this person or these people? Do I feel like I'm always going, I'm sorry, always giving and they're always taking? I need you to really ask yourself that question. Am I always given and they're always taken? Because a lot of situations, those of us on the outside looking in, we see it. And I've seen this before, how someone is always giving and these people are always taking, but the takers are never giving back. Do I feel like I have to walk on eggshells around this person or these people? Do I feel like I'm not being heard or respected? And last question, do I feel belittled or like my opinion or opinions don't matter? If you can answer yes to most of the questions that I just asked you, it's safe to say that you are being taken advantage of and it's time to put a stop to it. I know that a lot of you that may be dealing with this kind of stuff, you're nice people through and through, and it's hard for you to stand up to people that are using you. So number two, set and communicate your boundaries. It is important to set and clearly, I always like to preface the word clearly, communicate your boundaries to everybody. I said everybody that you deal with. I didn't say a few people. I didn't say only outsiders. I didn't say only family members. I said everybody that you deal with. The people you deal with must know what you will and won't tolerate. There should be no confusion about your boundaries. And when I say that, I need you to really hear the sincerity in my voice, because I mean that. There should never be any if, ands, or buts about, well, does she mean this or does she mean that? No, it should be clear about what your boundaries are. People should never have to question or second guess what you mean or don't mean. It should be so clear that a blind person could see it, okay? Number three, never be afraid to say no. It's hard to say no. And when you don't want to deal with conflict, but it's important to remember you have a right to say no, and your feelings matter, and you aren't obligated to please anybody. Now, if you are having a hard time saying no, then you may want to try these steps. The first one is know your limits and stick to them. Again, that's about being crystal clear. Number two, practice saying no when you're home alone. When you're home by yourself, practice saying no. Just looking in the mirror, talking to yourself, and say no. And say it with confidence. Number three, start saying no to the things that you really don't care about anyway. So if it's something that you truly don't care about anyway, just say no. Not that you can't do it, but just say no just to start getting into practice. And last but not least, be assertive and be assertive and firm when you do say no. Let me say this. When you do have to say no, I need you to be assertive and firm. Trust and believe. When Michelle tells you no, it's no. You don't have to second guess it. You don't have to wonder what I mean. You don't have to wonder what I was trying to say. If I really meant this, if I really meant that, if I really meant the other. When I tell you no, trust and believe, you know that I meant no. Now, I won't even lie to you. I won't. Depending on what it is and who it is, I may have to add some colorful words before it and or maybe after it. But there's no question about the fact that I said no. You don't have to wonder, well, maybe she really meant no. I was clear when I told you no. Remember, you are in control of your life and you decide what you will and won't do. It really is okay to say no. I know people, and I'll be honest with you, I'm raising my hand because I used to be that person. I used to always hate saying no. And when I say that, I mean specifically when it came down to doing things at church. If somebody asked me to do something or take on something or lead a committee, I'd say, sure, no problem. Inside, I was thinking, I don't really want to do this because sometimes I don't mind. Now, here's the thing. I don't mind working because I love the Lord, and anything that I can do that's pleasing to God, I don't have a problem with doing it. I don't always want to be in control of it or have to give leadership to it. I don't mind working, but I don't always want to lead whatever that thing is. And I would never say no. I think I shared that with some of you all before, but I was always the yes person. And finally, one day I said, Michelle, it is all right to say no. If you really don't have the time, if you really don't have the desire, say no. And so now I'm all right with saying, you know what? I don't want to give leadership to whatever that thing is. I don't mind helping out, but you're gonna have to find somebody else to give leadership to it, just because I don't have the time to do that. And to be quite honest with you, I really don't. Now, I know somebody in the back of the room is saying, but Michelle, we all have the same 24 hours in a day. And that what you said, zip it. I did say that. However, when I say I don't have the time, I don't. I work a full-time job. I still have a business to run, and I give my business 2 to 3 hours a day working on whatever it is that I'm working on, be it creating content or whatever it is I'm working on. I've got to give my own business 2 to 3 hours a day. Plus, I am working on editing projects. I'm working on writing projects of my own. So when I say I don't have time for something, I truly don't. Now, I don't mind the behind the scenes work. But I don't have time to give leadership where I have to make sure everybody's doing what they're supposed to be doing and everything comes together. That I just don't have time for. Now, I do give leadership to the part of our counseling ministry for those of us that don't have licenses to do counseling. I am a certified life coach. So that's different because I don't diagnose anything. All I'm doing is helping you work out your issues, okay? So I give leadership to that part of the counseling ministry, where Reverend Arnett gives leadership to the part of the ministry for the folks that are licensed to diagnose people. So I did say yes to that because that's where my heart is. And I do give leadership to our Another Chance ministry, which is a ministry that we're trying to really get up and running to help persons who have been incarcerated, you know, have another chance. And so I've taken on those things because they mean something to me. But other than that, I work throughout the church. I work on a committee, but I'm not going to give leadership to it because I just don't have the time. Okay. Yeah, I just thought I had to lay all that out for you so you'd understand when I said it's all right to say no. Number four, follow through with any consequences that you give. Now, I need you to listen carefully. If you make decisions, wait a minute, I'm sorry. If you make demands and don't follow through with them, people won't respect you. Let me stop right there. They will not respect you. You know what they're hearing? When you say, I'm not doing ABCXYZ. Oh, no. I'm sorry, wrong scenario. If you tell somebody, if you don't pay me my money back, I will never lend you anything else or give you anything else. You know what they're hearing? I hear her. How many times have I borrowed money from her and didn't pay her back? And here I am still borrowing money, okay? They don't respect you. That's why they keep coming back to ask, because they know you're going to give it to them because you have that soft spot in your heart and they have a need and you don't mind helping them. Even though you said before, if you don't give me my money back, I'm not giving you anything else. They don't really have respect for you, okay? And they won't believe you. So your follow through sends a clear message to people that you are very serious. I'm all about clarity. So if I say to you, I will do this for you, but if you don't do whatever it is that I'm asking you to do, or whatever it is I'm doing for you, if you don't fix it, or you don't give me my stuff back, or you don't do this, that, and the other, it's a wrap. I'm cutting you off. I now have to follow through with what I said because you did not do what I asked you to do. Remember, I set clear boundaries and you thought it was a joke not to follow through. So now not to do what I've asked you to do. So now I've got to follow through and I've got to cut you off. It's going to hurt me to do that, but I have to cut you off because if I don't, you're going to keep taking me for a joke. You're going to keep disrespecting me and you're going to keep thinking that I'm a liar and you're going to keep mistreating me, but you're going to keep using me. Okay? That's what you're going to do, because you know that I'm not a woman of my word. You know I say I'm going to do A, B, C, X, Y, Z, and I'm not going to follow through. Well, guess what, people? It's now time to follow through. You've been telling people for the longest time that if they keep doing what they're doing, you're going to do this, and you don't do it. Now is the time. Now you've got to put that size 8, that size 9, 10, 11, 12, 15, whatever size shoe you wear, it's time to put it down and show people, because you can show them better than you can tell them. And you're going to have to follow through. Like I said, it's not going to be easy at first. At first, it's not going to be easy, but you've got to do it. I promise you, you've got to do it. Just like I got somebody that I worked with, and every time I turned around, she would say, hey, can I borrow whatever? Because, you know, I don't have any groceries. I'll give it back to you on payday. Do you know how many paydays since August have come and gone and I haven't gotten my money back? And one time I actually lent her, because it was never a give, I lent her money to get groceries for her and her son, and I really didn't have it to give. That was my when I said I didn't have it to give, that was my vacation money. So that was back in August. I have yet, this is November, I've yet to get my money back. Do you know I've gotten a call from her four times since then, wanting to borrow money? But when I saw her name pop up on my phone, I didn't bother to answer it. I let that call go to voicemail. See, because I can show you better than I can tell you. I told you that if I lend you something else and you don't give it back, you can't borrow anything else from me. And I meant what I said. See, I had said that several times before. I didn't follow through. And because I have a good heart and I didn't want to see her not having anything to eat for her and her son, I lent her the money and I didn't get it back. So that's when I said, nope, Michelle, that's it. You got to cut it off. You have to cut it off, because if not, she's going to continue to use you. She's going to continue to use the fact that you are a parent just like she is. And so you understand that as a parent, we want to be able to provide for our kids. Now, mind you, her son is not a little kid. He's grown, okay, for all intents and purposes. He's not a little kid. So he technically can go out and get himself a part-time job to help around the house. But I digress. I had to follow through, and I meant what I said. So if I see her name pop up on my phone, I don't even bother to answer it. Somebody said, well, you ought to answer it. I said, no, for what? For what? So she can, Michelle, I hate to call you. I know I owe you some money, and I promise you, as soon as I get back on my feet, I'm going to give you what I owe you, but I don't have anything in my refrigerator. Can I please? And I have to go, girl, no, I can't. I don't even want to hear all of that. I don't want to hear it. I'm done with it. Go tell it to somebody else. But again, it's all about the follow through. You've got to follow through with, and you have to execute what you've said when you put your boundaries out there. Number 5, don't be afraid to end relationships. Some people will never respect you or your boundaries, no matter how many times you relay them. Let me say it again. Some people will never respect your boundaries, you or your boundaries, no matter how many times you relay them. So, or follow through with them. So again, the person I was telling you about that keeps wanting to borrow money, and I put my foot down and said that I'm gonna cut you off, and I had to cut her off. And you see, like I said, 4 times I've gotten a phone call within the last month and a half. And I know it was to borrow money. Because if otherwise, you could have just cash out me my money back. You didn't need to call me for that. I would see it. So some people are just not going to respect you or your boundaries or your follow through, no matter how many times you put it out there. So when this is the case, it may be time to end that relationship. Ending a relationship is never easy, but it will definitely be necessary. You deserve respect, and you should never settle for anything less. Keep in mind, you may have to end relationships with not only friends, but also with family members as well. I get it. It's hard. Like I said, it's hard to end relationships, especially if you've been knowing that person for a long time. But if they don't respect you, they don't respect your boundaries, why are they still around? Why? Even like I said, whether it's a friend or a family, a coworker, a neighbor, it doesn't matter. And it's even worse when it's a family, because now you still have to see that family member at the family reunion, at the Christmas dinner, at Thanksgiving dinner, at the Hallelujah Halloween night, or whatever it is that you all do as a family. You're still going to see some of those family members, and that makes it a little difficult, but you've got to cut them off. Now, understand this. I'm going to say this and I'm going to move on. I said you have to cut them off. I didn't say not to love them, because you are still called to love them. They're still God's children. Love them, yes, but you have to cut them off. So even if I see you at the family reunion, you know, I'll speak, hey, how you doing? You know, how are you? Hope all is well. You know, God bless you. But we're not hanging out. You can't borrow nothing from me. We don't need to talk on the phone. If you call me and you need some prayer, oh, I'll pray for you, because it costs me nothing to pray for anybody. I don't have a problem with praying for you. But outside of that, don't ask me for anything, because we no longer have that relationship. You messed that up because you would not respect me or my boundaries. And so it's as simple as that. Number six, last but not least, seek professional help. Seeking professional help can give you the guidance and support you need to move, make positive changes in your life. Your therapist can also, I'm gonna say therapist or counselor, can also help you work through your feelings and even understand why you keep attracting people that want to take advantage of you. Remember, you don't have to go through this alone. There's help if you need it. I know that a lot of times people don't want to seek counseling and or therapy or whatever you choose to call it, because they think it makes them weak, and so they don't want to. Oh, we don't do that. No, guess what? If you need the help, go get it. Because the reality is that some of us are, for whatever reason, I don't know, because like I said, I am not a licensed therapist, so I can't tell you why, but some people are just naturally drawn to folks who bring out the worst in them. Some people are naturally drawn to folks that want to use them, to want to break them down. I don't know why. I really don't, because like I said, I'm not a licensed therapist. I have a good friend of mine who I won't call by name, and he's nice as he can be. Goofy as hell, but he's nice. Excuse me, Lord. He's goofy, but he's sweet as he can be. He has a heart of gold, would give you the shirt off his back. And for some strange reason, he tend to attract women that like to use him and or always want to get over on him. And it's really sad to see. And he's one of these people that when he loves hard. He gives that relationship his all. But like I said, for some reason, he seems to meet these women that just want to use him. Now, it would be nice if he went and sought a therapist or counseling to find out what is it about him that draws these types of women to him, or what is it about him that causes him to be drawn to those type of women? Because, you know, most times men are seeking the women out. So he seems to seek out these women who are needy or users. That's why I said, if you feel like getting some type of help is necessary, do it. Don't worry about what other people are going to think and or say, because guess what? They don't even have to know that you're going to seek help. They won't know unless you tell them. But I would prefer that you go do that so that you can continue to be the best you possible. Because there is a reason why, like I said, again, I don't know what it is, but there is a reason why you keep being drawn to those types of people. Just watch people. See, I'm a people watcher. I always said I wish I could get paid just for watching people. Because there are people, I've watched people over the years, they always seem to attract the men that are cheaters. They always seem to attract the men who have nothing. And all they do is just milk them dry. Now, they're grown, so it's not my place to say, but it's like, why are you always going in your pocket for this man? Or why are you always going in your pocket for this woman? But these people, they always seem to seek out individuals that don't bring out the best in them, but just drain them. And then once they've drained those individuals, guess what? They're moving on because you got nothing else for them. So they got to move on now and go find somebody else to leech off of. So I'm pretty sure there is a reason why that happens. I don't know. And sometimes we just need to, you know what? I take that back. I think I know why. Because when you meet people, you got to pray. You got to pray. You got to ask God, Lord, is this the person for me? I know I do now. There was a time I'd be like, oh, he is fine. Oh, my goodness. You know, you get caught up and it's all good, whoop-de-woo. But as you start to live and you go through life, if I meet a guy, I'm like, all right, Lord, is this the man for me? Is this the person that you would have for me? Is this person coming into my life? Are they coming into my life with good intentions? Is this person coming into my life to make me a better person, or are they coming into my life to take from me and to drain me, Lord? Is this person coming into my life and they're a user? What are their intentions, Lord? I need you to reveal that to me. If this is not the right person for me, Lord, then I need you to show that to me. Show it to me early. Now, here's the catch. When you ask God to do that, He will do it. He will do it. I promise you that, because I've been down that road too many times. He will do it. The catch is sometimes we don't like what God shows us. And so we say, well, you know, Lord, I hear you, but I'm going to go ahead and give them a chance, because you're going off what they look like, what they have. Maybe they have this big, beautiful home, this nice car, you know, money in the bank. They love to travel and they love spoiling you, whatever the case may be. God spoke to you. You asked God to show you, and He said, nope, that's not the one for you. But you were so caught up with things that you said, okay, well, I'll look past that. I'll look past the fact that this person can't be faithful because they have money. I look past the fact that this person doesn't want anything out of life other than what they have. They're content with where they are. They have no ambitions. They have no life goals. I'll look past that because they're fine. They're handsome. They're cute. Whatever word you want to use, you'll look past all of that other stuff based on looks. Well, honey, guess what? We all are going to age. And the fine thing that you were in your teens, your 20s, 30s, and maybe even 40s, you're not going to necessarily look that way when you get up there in your 70s, 80s, and 90s. Let's just keep it real. And so I said all of that to say that when you ask God if somebody is the right person for you, you've got to be ready to receive what it is that He's going to tell you. And then it's up to you to act accordingly. God said, okay, I'm taking my hands off of it. You asked me, I told you, but this is who you're choosing anyway. So, hey, it's on you. And when it doesn't work out, you'll come back and say, all right, Lord, I should have listened. And He's going to say, I know. I told you. You just didn't want to listen. So, again, I said all of that to say, if you need to get help, then please do. Don't feel like you have to go through this by yourself. Like I said, I am not a licensed therapist, but I am a certified life coach. I am a mentor. So if you ever feel like you need to talk, in the description box, you'll see Linktree. Click on that, and my calendar is in there. All the ways that you can reach me is in there. Reach out, let's talk, because I don't want anybody feeling like they have to walk around and nobody cares, because I care. I want to help you at least get started moving in the right direction. But please never feel like you have to do this by yourself, because you don't. When I tell you I love you all and I truly care, I really do. And I mean that from my heart. I mean it from my heart. I care about you and I want nothing but the best for you. Now, having said that, you all go out there, enjoy the rest of your evening, whatever it is that you decide to do. I'm going to start off the conversation saying this. Make sure you have fun doing it, but do it in a safe manner. Be safe where you're going. Be careful of your surroundings, the people that you're with. Y'all know the drill. If you go someplace, don't be meeting folks, taking them back home. If you didn't go with them, don't you leave with them. okay? When you're in your car, even like right now, I'm sitting in my driveway. I live in a nice, quiet neighborhood, but I'm sitting in my driveway, and just out of habit, my doors are locked. You know why? Because I do it when I'm away from home as well. So I just do it everywhere. Stop sitting in your cars with your doors unlocked. All it takes is for you to get busy and somebody runs up, snatch your door open, jump in and say, drive off. So keep your doors locked. It's all about being safe. I know you think you're the big bad wolf and ain't nobody gonna bother you, but we live in a crazy world. We live in a world with people who don't care. They don't care about you. They don't care about me. And they sure as heck don't care about themselves. But I care. So I'm telling you, keep your doors locked. Keep your eyes peeled. Be careful of your surroundings. If they're neighborhoods you know you have no business being in, stay out of them. Okay? Because I want you to be safe. Having said that, if you're new to watching my videos, I want to say welcome. Thank you so much for joining me. I do car conversations every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday. So make sure you come back on Friday. And don't forget to hit this like, but the like button on this video and hit the subscribe button. Because when you like my video and you subscribe, it helps my channel tremendously. That's why my videos are getting seen by so many more people, and I'm so thankful for that. So please make sure you like and subscribe to this video. Subscribe to my channel, but like this video. And feel free to comment and let me know what your experience has been with being taken advantage of, if you choose to, okay? But I really would like to hear from you all. If this is not your first rodeo, I want to say welcome back. Y'all know I miss you when I don't get a chance to see you. Again, go out there, you guys. Have a great rest of the evening. We will talk again on Friday. Until then, I love you. And there's nothing, I mean absolutely nothing, that you can ever do about it. Because I'm going to always love you. That's my job, and I enjoy doing it. Take care, and we'll talk again Friday.